Linear regression is one of the most used tools in statistics. It's a tool to see how one or several variables affect another variable of interest. In this video, we focus on the simplest version of all linear regression models, which is the simple linear regression. We will cover other regression models in later videos. In this video, I will describe the five steps in linear regression model. Let's begin. So let's start with motivation for linear regression. Regression analysis, not excluded to linear regression analysis, is a technique to examine the relationship between a group of independent variables, x, and a dependent variable, y. Different textbooks and teaching resources may call x and y by different names. For example, X may also be known as explanatory variables, predictors, predictor variables, input variables, or regressors. Y is also known as a response variable, outcome variable, or regressant. Regression analysis helps us to understand or quantify the effect of each X on Y by setting up a mathematical or statistical model. Using this model, we are able to predict y based on the values of x. Regression analysis is particularly useful for many business applications. For example, managerial decisions are often based on the relationship between two or multiple variables. After considering the relationship between advertising expenditures and sales, a marketing manager can predict sales for a given level of advertising expenditures using regression analysis. So here, sales is the variable we try to predict, also known as the response variable or dependent variable. And advertising cost is the predictor, explanatory variable, or independent variable. Here are some more examples where regression analysis can be useful. Time spent studying the subject is very likely to be related to the test scores. We may be very interested to see whether an employee's gender and work experience affect his or her salary. The price of a certain product can be influenced by a supplier and market where it's being sold. In the first example, there is only one independent variable, 1x here, so this regression model is also called as a simple linear regression. In the second and third models, there are two independent variables. So these models are called multiple linear regression models. Linear regression differentiates itself from other types of regression models in that it is useful when the relationship between each x and y can be summarized using a straight line. This straight line well describes the scatter plot of x and y. Let's take a look at the scatter plot of study time versus test scores. It appears a linear regression model works quite well to describe the relationship between the independent variable study time and the dependent variable score. This is because most of the points lie not too far away from this straight line. This simple linear model is also known as the best fit line. It does just that, reporting the best possible guess for a straight line passing through a scatter plot. This is not a useful tool for detecting other kinds of relationships, though, like curves, which we're going to talk about on the next page. In some situations, linear regression model is not appropriate too. For example, repeating cycles, like the graph of seasonally affected data on the left, are not modeled well with a straight line. Growth curves are often logistic. That is to say, they start slow, grow very quickly for a while, and then taper off. Growth curves are often logistic. That is to say, they start slowly, grow very quickly for a while, then taper off. So these curves are also not described well using a straight line. The good news is, simple linear regression can be quite effective for the vast majority of situations. For the growth curve scatter plot, if we choose to only look at the middle section of this graph, a linear regression can be quite useful. We just need to use simple linear regression model with care and not extend it into regions which are not described well. Furthermore, while there are many, many variations on regression that we cannot possibly address easily, if we understand how simple linear regression works, we'll be well prepared to learn about and adapt to other regression techniques when needed. When the number of independent variables in a regression setting is 1, so that means there's only one x, it is called a simple linear regression. This is the simplest case among all linear regression models. When the number of independent variables in a regression setting is 2 and above, it is called a multiple linear regression. Let's take a look at one example. Butler Trucking Company is a trucking company in Central Oregon. A major portion of Butler's business involves deliveries throughout its local area. To develop better work schedule, a manager wants to predict the total daily travel time for his drivers. He collected 300 driving assignments. What's shown on this screen is a screenshot of the Excel spreadsheet provided by this trucking company. There are several pieces of information, also known as variables here. Each variable is represented using one column. The first column is the assignment number, starting from 1 all the way to 300. The second column is miles or distance driven measured in miles. For example, the first assignment involves a total of 100 miles of driving. Gasoline consumption is given in column C. The numbers are likely to be measured in gallons, as you can see here. The number of deliveries for each assignment is listed in column D. They're all whole numbers, as you can see. Column E, highway, only includes 1 or 0. This type of variable is also known as a binary variable or dummy variable because they only take 1 or 0 values and they represent yes or no. For example, for assignment number 1, highway is listed as a 0. So that means this particular assignment does not involve driving on a highway, whereas assignment 11, which is given here, it does involve driving on the highway. We will discuss binary variables in another video, which is linked in the upper right corner of this screen. The last column is time, represents the total travel time in hours for each assignment. Whenever we are dealing with a dataset with multiple variables, I highly recommend thinking about the property of each variable and the relationship among them. For example, you can ask yourself, is this variable numerical or categorical? Is this variable possibly related to any other variables in this dataset? Because their properties and relationships will play a critical role in modeling of this dataset. Let's take a look at how we can carry out analysis using linear regression. To carry out the linear regression analysis, it usually involves 5 steps. Before running any regression models, it is very important to determine what the exponential variables and what the response variables are. Usually, the exponential variables could be 1 or more, but there's always only one response variable. In step 2, we create a scatter plot for each x and y. If there are 2 x's, we would have to create 2 separate plots. This is to examine whether the relationship between each x and y is indeed linear. Remember, we are using linear regression to model the relationship between x and y. After checking the relationship is indeed linear, in step 3, we fit this model using a software such as Excel, ExcelStat, R, Python. In this video, I will use ExcelStat for demonstrations. Regardless of the software used, the regression outputs should be somewhat the same. In step 4, based on the output, we can write out our linear model and interpret the output. Step 5 is case-specific. We frequently use regression models for predictions, and we can do that in this step. I'm going to use the trucking company example to demonstrate the steps in linear regression.
The company manager would like to predict the total travel time for their drivers. So the variable he tries to model or explain is the time variable in column F. There are a few variables that may possibly affect time. For this video of simple linear regression, I will only focus on one of the variables, which will be miles in column B. If the driver have to drive far for assignments, the total travel time is very likely to be high as well. So in step 1, we identify the independent variable is miles and the dependent variable is time. In step 2, we check whether the relationship between miles and time is indeed linear. We can do that through two different approaches. The first approach involves a scatter plot. You can do that using Excel data analysis or Excel stat. Details on installation of Excel stat can be found on our course site. In Excel stat, just click on visualizing data and then scatter plots. I usually like to plot the dependent variable on the vertical axis and the miles, which is the independent variable, on the horizontal axis or x-axis. From the scatter plot, we can see that as miles goes up, time also goes up. We can generate scatter plots in Excel stat. So under Excel stat, click on visualizing data, scatter plots. So you get a dialog box. I'm using a PC, but the Mac version looks somewhat similar. So there's a bunch of variables for our trucking company. And the first thing I like to do is I like to click on here. And there are several options. You can use the mouse. If you see a table format is available, I like to use this one because this allows you to select the variables right away. So for X, that's horizontal axis. I like to plot miles on the horizontal axis. So you can select miles. For the vertical axis Y, I like to choose time. Okay, so I think it's the very last one. You can check it. Click OK. One thing you want to notice is you want to see whether variable labels are checked. Yes, variable labels are checked. I click OK. So you can see there is a scatter plot. So that's pretty neat. And I also like to remove all the grid lines in Excel. So you can do that by doing that. If you click on the triangle, it takes you back to the dialog box and also the spreadsheet that you were working on. I'm going to show you how you can do that using the mouse. Sometimes this table option is actually not available. So let's see how we can do that. So I choose a mouse. I want to select it. We're going to do the same thing as what we did earlier. So X horizontal axis, I like to choose miles. I use my cursor to click on the first one. And I'm going to press and hold Control and Shift. And then downward arrow. So it gets all the values selected. And it does not select the empty or blank cells. So for Y, we do the same thing. And that's going to be time. So select the first one. Hold Shift and Control, downward arrow. So you can see there, get selected. And I click OK. So you can see the same set of scatter plots. Right. That's pretty neat. So the relationship is positive. The pattern can be approximate using a straight line, which means the linear relationship between them is indeed valid. We also notice that observations scattered somewhat closely around this line, so the relationship is moderately strong. In conclusion, the relationship between miles and time is indeed linear. An alternative way to look at a relationship between two variables is to use a numeric metric known as a correlation coefficient. A correlation coefficient is a number between negative 1 and 1, with 1 meaning a perfect positive relationship. And a negative 1 means a perfect negative linear relationship. Certainly, correlation 0 means there isn't any linear relationship at all. It is very important to note that correlation coefficient only measures linear strength between a pair of variables.
Sometimes, we may have two variables that are highly related, but just not in a linear way. The correlation may show up very small, maybe somewhere close to zero. Looking at the correlation coefficient alone, we may think there is no relationship between them. But in reality, these two variables are actually highly related. For a situation like this, correlation is not an appropriate way to measure the relationship between these variables. How could we calculate this correlation coefficient then? In Excel Stat, we click on Modeling Data, then Linear Regression. After selecting the variables for X and Y, a table, also known as correlation matrix, will appear in the output. Let's take a look at what we got for miles and time. Their correlation is estimated to be 0.694. That's moderately high, because the highest we can get is positive 1. We also see that miles and miles are perfectly positively correlated. Same goes for time and time. No surprise, a variable always has positive 1 correlation with itself. In conclusion, using either the first scatter plot approach or the second correlation approach, we are able to conclude that miles and time are linearly related. This indicates that we can use a linear regression model to model them. In step 3, we fit a linear regression model using a software. I use ExcelStat to do that. For a video on how to run linear regression using ExcelStat, please click on the linked video in the upper right corner. Here are different parts of the output. They can be largely divided into coefficient table or model parameter table that includes the intercept and also the slope that will be helpful for us to write down the model, and also the ANOVA table, the goodness of fit table. I will talk about the details in these three tables later in this video. I'd like to point out that the ANOVA table for regression is related to the ANOVA analysis in comparing the population means we talked about in one of the earlier videos. But the format of this table is different from that table. For a quick recap of ANOVA analysis in comparing means, please click on the linked video in the upper right corner of this screen.